It's rain and threes. Incredible, really. And if you look at the history that they made tonight, the combined also 25 made. The only reason this game is 5 points, though, turnovers. 11 by Utah that led to 17 points for the Clippers. So their defense started to have an impact their last 4 minutes to get them back in it. Can they sustain it defensively? If they can, they got a great chance here tonight.
And we've got inside tracks from Quinn Snyder of the Jazz.
If you focus here and use your voice for them, use your voice on transition deep. That's what you got to take care of with me. Okay, let's go.
Good stuff between the Utah head coach and the star of the Utah Jazz, Donovan Mitchell, Ian Eagle, Greg Anthony, Rebecca Harlow. We came here for game 5 of the Western Conference semis. Who knew that it would feel like an all-star game? That's how the offense was flowing.
It was incredible. I had no idea that we would see anything remotely close to that.
Terrence Mann is fouled. Rudy Gobert completely disagrees with the call, and Mann is going to the free throw line for LA. We're checking with Rebecca.
Well, Ian, if you like this offense, you'll be happy with Clips assistant Chauncey Billups and what he had to say at the half. He said he loves the tempo and the pace. He wants the Clippers to keep getting buckets in transition so that Utah can't set up their defense. But on the other end, he said also we have to limit the threes, of course. Rotations, run these guys off the three-point line here in the second half, guys.
All right, Rebecca, put your takes to the test. The FanDuel's free over-under game is simple. Just pick over or under for each clock for your chance to win. Head to FanDuel.com/over-under to make your free picks before every NBA on TNT broadcast. A three-point lead for the Jazz, but no free throws for Terrence Mann.
And I thought that was a smart decision by Quinn Snyder not to challenge there. Did not think it was a foul, but the right decision. No need to waste it in what could be a game that comes down to the end.
O'Neal defended by the smaller Jackson. O'Neal takes it to the rim.
And those kinds of plays by Royce O'Neal, who continues to have a positive impact, so important. You're getting contributions from other guys out there offensively.
George got hit hard by O'Neal, and George popped up off the floor. The officials get in between, so do his teammates. And they're going to take a look. Was this excessive?
I don't know what was excessive about that. Okay, there you go. You saw the grab with the right hand.
Yeah, it was the hug.
Yeah.
He got him around the neck. And that is what Paul George was ticked off about immediately when he went down. You'll see George then pop up.
Yeah. And in fairness, though, I don't think he grabbed him when he had the hand on him. You know what I mean? Like, he didn't pull him down. So I can see how Paul would be frustrated with that, and he has been aggressive, staying in attack mode, which is going to be incredibly important for the Clippers here.
Paul didn't get up and charge at O'Neal. He got up, and there was a look, and it really was more towards the official. So O'Neal gets him around the neck area with the right arm.
I think had he, when that hand was there, had grabbed him, no doubt they'd call it, but you know, emotions are running high in this game, so the officials don't want to lose control.
Call review, a flagrant foul, penalty 1, has been assessed to for a contact above.
Well, there you have it. Flagrant 1 on Royce O'Neal, and John Goble delivers the news. That's what Paul George was looking for, he got it.
So I think that's what, if I were Utah or the rest of the Clippers, anytime something happens, jump up quick and put the onus on the officials. I didn't personally like that call, only because I didn't feel like he pulled him. I felt like he had an arm there and then let go.
George at the free throw line, scan for your shot to experience everything Courtside has to offer. Michelob Ultra is giving you the chance to win tickets to the NBA playoffs, as well as some other amazing prizes.
numbers are strong for Paul George. 24 points, 8 rebounds in 19 minutes in the absence of Kawhi Leonard, who is not with the team. He is back in California.
And only one turnover. I mean, he has been the best player on the floor tonight, which you felt like he'd have to be in order for them to come in here shorthanded and win a game.
Jackson missed him at a running one-hander. Offensive rebound. Man, he's got the big. Man has got the bucket.
That's another big-time play there by Man, coming up with that offensive rebound. And then how about the confidence there by that jump shot?
It is a 10-2 run, bridging the second and third quarter. Ingle shooting practice off the mark, and the Clippers can take the lead. George looking for an opening. Get up, Morris. Ready, fire, got it, a three.
Paul George with the push in transition, and Morris with the patience on that triple.
And L.A. up by two, Ingles the fake, and a bucket off the window.
Great job of understanding with Gobert down there that help is not going to come.
There's Bam, one done for L.A. No rebounders for Los Angeles underneath.
No, I get a sense that it's getting close to Donovan Mitchell's time. But he's going to have to start him pouring his will, I think, and holding his will, I should say, on this game offensively.
After the Mitchell miss, George sees an opening, finishes with an offhand. PG-13 with a sweet move to the rack.
Playing with tremendous force, and Gobert a little hesitant, it seems, at contesting at the rim here to start this second half.
71-69, and they're taking the crowd out of it. Paul George is 10 of 15 from the field. Bogdanovich at the hot first half. Step back, Jay. Short. And a loose ball foul. O'Neal ended up on his rear end.
Well, what's happening is the game slowing down. And that's really to the advantage of the Clippers. They're the more physical and better defensive team in terms of one-on-one defense. And Paul George there just continuing to put forth a special performance here for the Clippers.
Terrence Mann picks up the personal foul. That is his second first team foul. Bogdanovich started 6 of 6 from three-point territory. And Boyan is now one of his last 8. Mitchell, tight shoulder fake. Left hand, but the goal, the foul.
And that's, to me, what has to happen. Aggression. He first really shot inside the three-point line for him, and he's able to get to the rim and get to the free throw line. That's something he has done consistently throughout the course of this series. But tonight, with that great start, he's been a little more reluctant, and rightfully so, with how well they shot that ball.